mothers and fathers of the Albion race from being able to marry into our family. That's why it was created. But aha, the script got flipped again. Because what happened is sheetrock became so popular and so inexpensive that it's everywhere. It's the predominant building material in houses today. And what happened is the Albion started to use it in their homes in the suburbs. And what happened? Divorce rate shot up, right? Teen pregnancies, unwed mothers shot up. And now in their community, there's chaos. Yes. And then what did they do? They destroyed all of those high rises. There are how people were living. They had alabaster in there, and they disseminated them back out into the row houses in the community where what? There's no alabaster. In most of those old houses in the community, they just painted and did some stuff, and in almost all of them, there's no alabaster.
And you know, the depression said that thing, and they also, you know, you know, about 35 years ago, we lived in a house and it made no difference. The lead paint kept it, people weren't aware 40 years ago.
Yes.
The lead paint kept it from seeping through.
Yes.
They sent people into your home,
yes,
and
right,
burned the paint off the wall.
Get rid of the
chaos.
To let the alabaster come
through.
Right. Because lead encapsulates. I'm sorry. Lead will encapsulate.
Right.
But just like you wear the leg thing when you're taking the x-ray.
Right.
Yes. But even with the leg, some of it was still getting through, yes, because you still had the problem.
Right.
But after they did that, you're right, it destroyed them even more.
Yes. What can you put on the walls in place of that shit, right?
Plywood.
Plywood.
There's all kinds of plywood. Jeremiah can tell you about
plywood.
All kinds of plywood. Pine, cedar,
yeah, I've seen
oak,
some nice ones.
Walnut, mahogany, all kinds of plywood, and the price is not that much different. But nobody wants to buy plywood anymore because automatically they go and do gypsum. Yes.
Now, in the video here, it speaks of the alabaster box. Well, what does that really mean?
It says right here, beware gifts. Beware strangers bearing gifts. And this is one of the reasons why officials in government are not allowed to receive gifts. Because it might be alabaster, it might be an alabaster ashtray, it might be a little alabaster doll. So they make, you know, dolls out of that stuff. It might be a little alabaster pipe or some little trinket, a necklace out of alabaster. And what do you know? There you have it. And there it is in your home. You better go home and destroy all these little bastards.
You know, like you said, they have a room. Every time they send the mayor a gift, they got a room almost as big as everything that he's gotten in the last 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
He takes nothing home.
Good.
They catalog.
Good.
Like I said, why did he have all this stuff and don't take it home?
They take it after the term is up. But see, they don't have anybody doing this time when they don't do that.
No.
Okay?
No.
Right? And chances are he already has it in his house. They even have the little columns, you know, the pretty little Greek Ionic columns on, and they look like little pedestals. That's alabaster. You better get rid of it.
Yes. In some government buildings, like in UK, I mean, also in Boyka, they had the gypsum boards in the offices,
mm-hmm,
and they just blow them down.
Mm-hmm.
Because all the problems between the employees or something like that. And also, what they're doing, like in places like today, Catholic Church started making all these virgins for the baby in the hands and in alabaster.
Alabaster, that's right, the little Jesus figurines and all that.
And every family, and
they had their country,
they
did that on purpose.
Yeah, and had that. They started making plates, you know, for people to be working in with that kind of stuff.
Plates?
Oh, yeah.
Made of alabaster.
Plates?
Plates? I didn't know that.
Remember those,
you know, ornaments.
Some of those old houses got
ornamental plates.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
The slat and the plaster, was that any good?
The what?
The old slats and the plaster.
Slats on
the wall. Behind the wall. On the wall. Which slats and plaster? Was that?
Oh, you know another name for it? Oh, yeah. Plaster pouch.
So that wasn't no good either.
No.
Oh.
And the craft show.
The arts and crafts.
Oh, yeah, arts and crafts, right, yeah, sure. You really think I can do it? All right, so that's that. So, a solid war going on? You think there's not a solid war going on out there? You're mistaken. There's been a solid war going on against us for hundreds of years. Hundreds, if not a couple of thousands of years, and here we are, silent, mumbling the word. You know, like a little mumble. Mama. See no evil, speak no evil, hear no evil. Yes, yeah, Mama. A few more minutes. All right? So, is that a testament to your silent war? That's just a little bit. I haven't begun to tell you about the silent war. All right, number four, the chosen people. Who are they? We read about them all the time in the Bible. Everybody claims to be them.
Yes.
Are you them? Say the Jews. The Jews are the chosen people. Are they?
We're the Jews.
But we are the Jews.
We're the elves.
Huh?
We're the elves. They're not the elves.
Right, we're both.
Okay. You're both. Okay. There's another scripture that tells you that the Egyptians are the chosen people.
I've never seen that, and you know what, huh? That the Egyptians are the chosen people?
Egypt.
Oh, well, you know where Egypt is.
Yeah.
In the womb. Okay, so that's from that standpoint. Okay, but now, the chosen people are the Moors. Of course. No one else. Why the Moors? Why them? What do they have that's different, that's special? Why should they be the chosen people?
Spirit.
Come on, let's give me a little more. Huh?
They have originality. They came from Zodiac.
Yes.
The Elohim, when we were in the image and in their rights, but they were the things that existed.
The Elohim. There you go. Yeah, it's Elohim too, but it's this. The vibratory rate of the Moors is so high. What even brings you close to this information? It's the vibratory rate of your bloodline. I'm going to tell you something that's so deep. I don't know if Charles A. mentioned this the other night in class about blood transfusions and all that, about cleaning the blood.
Yes, he did.
He talked about that you can't do it.
Right.
Well, some of you may not have seen this. That you can't take the blood out of your body, clean it, and put it back in. The whole idea of it is ludicrous. Because there's only one way to clean blood, and that is
Oxygen
breathed in. Now, how else are you going to get the oxygen into the blood? Through a vacuum tube, inject it in there like you do, you know, you can inject carbon dioxide into water, you can carbonate a liquid, right? And even when you get into a pool of water and you see the little bubbles and stuff on your skin, is that oxygen? It's not. That's your body breathing out. Your body does not breathe out oxygen. It's not possible. You breathe out what? And only carbon dioxide. Nothing. So now, if it's in your bloodline, and there's no way to clean your blood outside of your body, the vibratory rate of your blood is already instilled in you from your mother. No one can change that. No one can go into your bloodstream and change your vibratory rate. Not possible, right? The only one who can change your vibratory rate is you. No one else can do that. You change your vibratory rate according to one thing and one thing only. Information that you take in. because of course the DNA is the master. Columns, you know, the pretty little Greek Ionic columns, and they look like little pedestal stands. That's alabaster. You better get rid of it.
Yes. In some government buildings, like in UK, I mean, also in Boynton, they had the gypsum boards in the offices, and it just blows them down. Because all the problems between the employees or something like that. And also, what I started doing, like in places like UK, I was Catholic Church started making all these virgins for the baby and the hands and in alabaster.
Alabaster, that's right, the little Jesus figurines and all that.
And every family, and
they had their country, they did that on purpose.
Yeah, they had that. They started making plates, you know, for people to be working in. We got kind of
plates?
Oh, yeah.
Made of alabaster. Plates? I didn't know that.
Remember those,
you know,
some of those old houses got
ornamental plates.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
The slat and the plaster, was that any good?
The what?
The old slats and the plaster.
Slats on
what? Behind the wall. On the wall. Wood slats and plaster, was that?
Oh, you know another name for it? Oh, yeah. Plaster Paris.
So that wasn't no good either.
No.
Oh.
In the craft show.
Arts and crafts.
Oh, yeah, arts and crafts. Right, yeah, sure. That's all about it. You're really
confused?
All right, so that's that. So, a solid war going on? You think there's not a solid war going on out there? You're mistaken. There's been a solid war going on against us for hundreds of years. Hundreds, if not a couple of thousands of years, and here we are, silent, mumbling the word. We don't feel like a little mumble.
Mama.
See no evil, speak no evil, hear no evil.
Mama.
Yes, David. A few more minutes.
Mama.
All right? So, is that a testament to your silent war? That's just a little bit. I haven't begun to tell you about the silent war. All right, number four, the chosen people. Who are they? We read about them all the time in the Bible. Everybody claims to be them.
Yes.
Are you them? They're the Jews. The Jews are the chosen people. Are they? But we are the Jews.
We're the elves.
Huh?
We're the elves. They're not the elves.
Right. We're both.
Okay.
We're
both. Okay. There's another cause that this tells you that the Egyptians are the chosen people also.
I've never seen that,
it's
and you know what?
Huh?
That the Egyptians are the chosen people?
Egypt. Egyptian people.
Oh, well, you know where Egypt is.
Yeah.
In the womb. Okay, so that from that standpoint. Okay. But now, the chosen people are the Moors. Of course. No one else. Why the Moors? Why them? What did they do? Because you still had the problem.
Right.
But after they did that, you're right. It destroyed them even more.
Yes. What can you put on the walls in place of that shit?
Plywood.
Plywood.
There's all kinds of plywood. Jeremiah can tell you about them.
Plywood.
All kinds of plywood. Pine, cedar,
yeah, I've seen
oak.
Some nice ones.
Walnut, mahogany, all kinds of plywood, and the price is not that much different. But nobody wants to buy plywood anymore because automatically they go into gypsum.
Yeah.
Yes.
Now, in the video here, it speaks of the alabaster box. Well, what does that really mean?
It tells you right here. Beware gifts. Beware strangers bearing gifts. And this is one of the reasons why officials in government are not allowed to receive gifts. Because it might be alabaster, it might be an alabaster ashtray, it might be a little alabaster doll. So they make, you know, dolls out of that stuff. It might be a little alabaster pipe or some little trinket, a necklace out of alabaster. And what do you know? There you have it. And there it is in your home. You better go home and destroy all these little bastards.
You know, like you said, they have a womb. Every time they send the mayor a gift, they got a womb almost as big as everything that he's gotten in the last 2 years. Mm-hmm. He takes nothing on it. Good, they catalog. Good. Like I said, why did he have all this stuff that I'm taking home?
They take it after they're terminated. But see, they don't have anybody doing this kind of analysis to do that.
No.
Okay?
No.
Right? And chances are he already has it in his house. They even have the little mothers and fathers of the Albion race from being able to marry into our family. That's why it was created. But aha, the script got flipped again. Because what happened is sheetrock became so popular and so inexpensive that it's everywhere. It's the predominant building material in houses today. And what happened is the Albions started to use it in their homes in the suburbs. And what happened? Divorce rates shot up. Right? Teen pregnancies, unwed mothers shot up. And now in their communities, there's chaos. Yes. And then what did they do? They destroyed all of those high rises. There are people who were living. They had alabaster in there. And they disseminated them back out into the row houses in the community where what? In most of those old houses in the community, they just painted and did some stuff, and in almost all of them, there's no alabaster.
And you know that the preacher said that thing, and they also, you know about 35 years ago, we lived in a house, and it made no difference. The lead paint kept people warm wear 40 years ago.
Yes.
The lead paint kept them seeping through.
Yes.
And they sent people into your home,
yes,
and
right,
burned the paint off the wall.
To get rid of the lead.
And
let the alabaster come
through.
Because lead encapsulates. Lead will encapsulate.
Right.
But just like you wear the lead thing when you're taking the x-ray.
Right.
Yes. So but even with the lead, some of it would still get half. This difference is special. Why should they be the chosen people?
Spirit.
Come on, let's give me a little more.
You had originality that came from Zodiac.
Yes.
The Elohim, when you were in the image and in their right, but they were the things that existed.
The Elohim. There you go.
Zodiac.
Yeah, it's an Elohim too, but it exists. The vibratory rate of the Moors is so high. What even brings you close to this information? It's the vibratory rate of your bloodline. I'm going to tell you something that's so deep. I don't know if Charles A. mentioned this the other night in class about blood transfusions and all that, about cleaning the blood.
Yes, he did.
You talked about that. That you can't do it.
Right.
Well, some of you may not have seen this. That you can't take the blood out of your body, clean it, and put it back in. The whole idea of it is moot. Because there's only one way to clean blood, and that is
oxygen.
Breathed in. Now, how else are you going to get the oxygen into the blood?